Today, our entertainment correspondent Peter Morris finds out more about how his family influences his music, and he gets to the bottom of a few rumours about the past.
What a beautiful noise.
Another Neil Diamond song that sits comfortably among the pop classics and still sounds as fresh today as it did when he wrote it, inspired by a chance remark from his daughter.
Beautiful Noise was actually, it was my daughter's idea. I was with my daughters in New York City, staying in a hotel, and we were all drawing in one of the rooms, drawing pictures, and outside the window was a parade. And we were looking at the parade and all the noise coming up from the parade to the hotel room. And Marjorie, my eldest daughter, said, "Daddy, what a beautiful noise." And I said, "Marjorie, tonight we're going to write a song called Beautiful Noise." It just struck me as something that only a child could think of, you know? And that night I wrote Beautiful Noise from beginning to end. And the kids sang with me and they sang in the chorus. It was just pure kismet, pure accident, and wonderful too.
As you probably gathered, Neil's family mean a great deal to him. And while he's largely kept them out of the limelight till now, you can tell he's as proud as any dad to have his son Jesse touring with them. And of course, it keeps the costs down.
It's just good fun for me, really. I mean, I don't get paid, and I'm just really along to have a great time. That's all it is for me.
I told him that the band doesn't get paid. We just have fun and just, it's okay.
And you believe that?
No.
No, but I mean, did you obviously, have you encouraged Jesse to get involved in the music business? You say he's been playing since six.
He has. He's been playing on stage since he was six, mostly so I could keep an eye on him when I was on the road. And he took to it. He loves it. He plays drums. He writes music. He's a terrific writer. And he's now taking guitar and, you know, it's a pleasure for me to have him with me. It's a big kick. It's something that I dreamed about for a long time. I was on the road. I thought someday maybe I'll take Jesse with me, you know. So he's with me.
Oh, right away.
Right?
Right.
And the pay is meaningless to him. He doesn't get paid for the first 5 years.
He doesn't seem to be doing too badly on it, though, does he? But while Dad is now a superstar, recognized internationally, it seems at one stage talent wasn't enough, and his old record company created a whole new history to make him more interesting.
Well, that was with the Bang Records, the record company that I had my first really big hit records with. But they wanted to invent a persona that was popular at that time. It was kind of like the Bob Dylan persona. You know, he's kind of like a rebel without a cause, or, you know, the James Dean kind of thing. That's what they saw me as. So they made up a life for me, that I was a troubled kid and I ran away from home and I started my own musical group when I was 12. No, I didn't take a music lesson until I was 16. And it just went out and it never disappeared. I was, the real truth is that I was born and raised in Brooklyn. I never ran away from home because I got fed every night. Why would I run away? I started taking music lessons when I was 16 or 17. I wrote my first song to my girlfriend when I was 17. It's the one I mentioned, Hear Them Bells. I've been writing ever since. I hope to write until, you know, there's nothing left in me.
But while he's happy being who he is, it seems Neil did once contemplate changing his name.
I had Ice Cherry and Noah Kaminsky as possible backup names in case I, chickened out. But no, this Neil Diamond is my name, has always been my name. Since I was born, that's the name I was given. I'm glad I didn't change it to Noah Kaminsky. I'm glad I didn't change it to Ice Cherry. I mean, how would it be introducing my kid? Hey, this is Jesse Cherry. Come here, Jesse. Jesse, come over here. Come here. Come over here. Let's see if he responds to Jesse Cherry. Jesse, this is Jesse Cherry.
Right.
Yeah. Jesse Kaminsky.
Jesse Kaminsky. I like that one better.
What's your choice? Kaminsky, Diamond, or Cherry?
Kaminsky.
Kaminsky. Okay, get out of here.
I like that one.
Well, Diamond's certainly easier to spell than Kaminsky, but I don't suppose the name really matters too much when you can sound like this, even in rehearsal.
Watching that was Smokey Robinson. Good morning again, Smokey. And in fact, you're friendly with Neil Diamond, aren't you?
Yes, Neil's a wonderful person. He's a great guy.
Yeah. And there was another link. We saw Neil working with his son, and your family, some of your family anyway, work with you, didn't they?
My son, yeah. In fact, my oldest son Barry. He's 23, and he is now about to start back in college. He goes to sound engineering school. And for a year, he's been working with me on my concerts.
For your money.